Tech. Good afternoon, Boomi fans, and welcome back to Dallas, Texas. We're here on day two, coming to the close of our coverage here at Boomi World 2025. My name is Savannah Peterson, hanging out with Paul for all the live action.
Certainly are. That's going to be fun.
Yeah, it is going to be fun. You know, and we fun like swag. We were just talking about swag right before we got started, and we actually have some former swag champions over here. Itamar and Taylor, thank you so much for coming to hang out with us. This is going to be a really fun one. You're new members of the Boomi fam post-acquisition. How's that been? Itamar, I'm going to start with you since it was your company.
Yes, I was the CEO at Rivery, and we acquired by Boomi end of last year, like December last year. And in the past 5 months, it's really great experience for us, and this is our first Boomi World.
Well, welcome to the
Boomi World. Much interactions, and really enjoyed the moment.
Yeah, that sounds good. I can tell from your big smile and energy that you actually mean what you're saying right there. Yeah. Taylor, how about you? What's it been like for you?
Yeah, it's been great. I led pre-sales at Rivery and now leading the data integration group pre-sales here at Boomi. And I just got out of a session. It was awesome. The engagement, giving demos at the booth. So, yeah.
Yeah, what a great story though, a better together story. It's super powerful. Yeah, the what is it now? Boomi Data Integration, right? That's the new name.
Yeah, we announced it today.
Yeah, oh, that's fantastic. Yeah, that's great.
Presented that one, announced that one. Today,
yeah, that's great. I mean, it really aligns nicely with the heritage of Boomi and like where the foundational pieces, but also it takes it into that next wave, right? Where AI is going, where the connections are going, how the data works. Because obviously, applications without data mean nothing, right? So you have to have that integration in place in order for it to work. But I really like where your positioning of bridging the old with the new, with the heritage data, with the new data, that makes a lot of sense. What are your thoughts with this acquisition and how it's moving forward and how's it going to accelerate what you've been doing?
Yes, absolutely. I think that this is one of the reasons that we decided to join Boomi. I think that the vision and the strategy to go towards the AI, it's definitely something that we love. And I think that if you think about that, Rivery, the pre-order, what is today, the Boomi data integration, brings a lot of experience around the data and especially data analytics. When you think about Boomi, that in basically the founders of the integration and automations into basically business processes. And you think about that, AI rely a lot on data plus business processes and automation. So I think that these two elements and two great assets together bring us as a Boomi platform to be in a very good position towards this mission.
Totally makes sense. Taylor, what are your thoughts? I mean, is it exciting? Is this going to help like drive the forward?
Totally. I think like with bringing Boomi data integration, I think modernizes that piece of the Boomi product. And we're thinking about data pipelines in terms of larger workloads at scale, replicating from databases, efficiencies when we're loading data into data cloud data lakes, data warehouses, like all of this we can do now at scale with Boomi data integration and the post-load transformations to like model your data and prep it for the downstream analytics. So that's like, we can do that now with Boomi's existing iPaaS capabilities, kind of all in one platform.
Yeah.
I think just means more use cases in one platform.
That's great.
Yeah, more solutions, more coverage, it's pretty lovely. How's the transition been for your community, for your existing customers and coming over into the Boomi world? What's that been like? Itamar, I'll go to you first.
Yes, I think that in general, most of our customers really loved the idea that we will, you know, part of something much bigger. And again, it makes the synergy between the two assets that we're bringing to the table. I think it makes a lot of sense for the market, and this is, we got a lot of great feedback from the industry, from our customers, and from Boomi customers. You ask me why I'm smiling a lot. I see I'm a person of growth. I'm a serial entrepreneur. I always want to grow and to increase revenue, and what I see here is the potential, you know, the potential of 23,000 customers. That's all of them basically relevant for
Instant
the Boomi
boost,
data
right?
integration. Exactly.
Yeah, that's great.
It is great. And you can tell. And sometimes with acquisitions that can get kind of messy, but it's nice to hear that this has been such a positive, and it's a great fit. I mean, it makes perfect sense. It's not like you need me to say that. Y'all already made that call. Taylor, talk to me a little bit about the use cases that you're able to unlock, and particularly the for SAP.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
So actually something that was, we found a synergy early on, even you know, before the acquisition was official, was that Boomi has strong capabilities around SAP, one of which called Boomi for SAP, that integrates with a bunch of different SAP services. And then we can actually pair that with Rivery's data pipelines, not Boomi Data Integration's data pipelines, to extract SAP data for the purpose of, you know, large scale extraction for downstream analytics, which before in Boomi was largely just for integrating SAP with other systems. So it really like evolves the SAP landscape within the Boomi platform and opens up like a whole new channel for our customers too.
I bet that's exciting.
Yeah.
You have a pretty cool job.
Yeah, I hope so.
I bet people really enjoy working with you. You know, data teams are really in an interesting spot right now. I mean, obviously data powering our AI future. It's got to be good data. It's got to be clean data. How are you empowering them to accelerate and to continue to keep up with the velocity that we're currently operating at? Taylor, I'll start with you on this one. And bring
yeah,
it back to
I you. Mean, I think, you know, data teams, there's been this ongoing struggle or battle to prove ROI, to work with productivity. I think AI is a huge part of that, where it presents a lot of opportunity, but also could add a bunch of you know, tasks to their list of like, hey, now we need to do the embed AI into everything. So I think having consolidated in one platform where you know, you can kind of compound value, being able to produce use cases all in the same data sets, but maybe for different purposes. And then when you surround that or wrap that with AI agents that you can build and govern in Boomi, it can you know, essentially build a flywheel, I think, of value.
I think that's a really good point you just made, actually, and all those use cases. Go for it. I can tell you want to chime in.
Yes, I think that the opportunity for us is also, speaking about what we want to address, is taking the great assets that we have and make it even much more, much bigger. As a GM of data management, my mission is the next 12 months to make the Boomi data platform, as part of the Boomi platform, to be really market leader on this one. So we are coming with the data integration, we cover this box and in a great way. We have the data hub that helping us for, you know, for the golden records management, and definitely help us in cleansing the data set and make it much better quality in order to serve the AI agents that we are going to develop, but also to expand that one into the observability, catalog of data, and what we are actually launching end of next month, which is the data connector agent. It will be the first in the market that doing this one. So instead of waiting for us to develop native connectors, the users itself and all Boomi's consumers will be able to build connectors on the fly via AI agent that we created in the past 18 months.
So I want to kind of double click a little bit onto that, because I mean, I think that the technology matters. So you talked about the data hub, and I think the data hub really is going to be an interesting kind of approach. Adding in the MDM capabilities, and then, you know, if you get into like the really tactical pieces of like, all right, if you use an ETL and you're kind of moving data around and such, what does it mean for, or, you know, for organizations with this new kind of tech stack that's kind of coming together, and how does Boomi kind of help accelerate what you were previously doing in your vision?
I think that today it's all about metadata and metadata management. So I think that the fact that we have a product, a data integration, a Boomi data integration, that it's all about the metadata engine. This is how we are generating the processes, how we are executing those data flows. Combining this one and integrating with the data hub or the MDM capabilities that we already have in Boomi, definitely going to generates great value for the customers, because today customers want to make sure that, you know, to address their data initiative, that anyway it's a bit complex, to do it with one product that help,
yeah,
you know,
sure,
that synergy like 1 + 1 = 3, and this is the typical case here.
Yeah. Taylor, what are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, no, I totally echo that. I think, you know, before, Rivery was a standalone ELT product.
Yeah.
You can build a data pipeline end to end, right? And now, you know, wider capabilities, like being able to kind of govern those data sets and manage them,
which
master data them,
yeah.
define your
yeah.
golden record yeah. so that you can actually even have bi-directional syncs between hub and your warehouse. Like, I think it just extends the tangential use cases that you can cover in one place.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does, and it's really exciting. I'm curious for you both personally, so, well, which of these use cases get you most excited? What are you most excited to see what customers are going to do? Taylor, I'll start with you since you just were just
I mean, saying. I think the data connector agent is going to be huge. I think it's, one, it's like AI prompted where you can essentially, you know, talk to AI and then you get back essentially a definition of a data pipeline. And what's nice about that is it's, you know, there's no black box. You get that,
yeah.
that YAML definition and you can tweak it and you get it, you know exactly what's happening. You just get that accelerated time to value. I think, and then it, you can, you know, we can make a marketplace and have partners help build them.
Yeah.
So I think it's, I don't know, there's a lot of potential.
Really. Not to put words in your mouth, but it also makes it more dynamic, right?
Yeah.
So like versus like historically, yeah. that was hard coded.
Right.
Right, and that was a very fixed way of
Point
doing
ball.
Things, right?
Yeah.
So I like the flexibility that you're bringing to the table here.
Flexibility, this is the big thing here. It's, as Taylor mentioned, it's not like a black box, you're looking for connector and we are building for you. We are building for you and the way that we are providing as a YAML configuration file to the users, then you can take it to
Adjust
another
and,
step
yeah,
ahead and modify it. I would add on top of that one the large scale of CDC integration. I think this is something that we are hearing a lot of demands of for companies that moving to the cloud and they definitely looking for a modern way to replicate data from their legacy databases at scale. So I think that this one, the native engine, CDC engine that we built in the Boomi data integration definitely going to serve us and our customers at scale.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, I've got two final questions for you here. On the weekends, or in your other lives, not in your professional lives, what do you hope, what gets you most excited about our AI future? Itamar, I'm going to start with you.
AI features. So, in general, in the weekend, I like to play soccer, and I don't think about. You know what? I have a connection to the AI. We have a camera in the fields that all rely on AI, so it takes the picture and the video of the entire game and summarizing end of the game. So we are standing between friends, and that was a penalty. That was a good nice goal.
We're
and
love this.
It's actually
yeah.
helping you to improve yourself. So definitely, this is. My piece of AI in my weekend. So
I heard AI is helping him determine who's buying the beers at the end of the game.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what I heard.
Yeah. That sounds like it. What about you, Taylor?
Oh man, I don't know. I feel like my weekends, I'm still thinking about work. So yeah, I mean, I think, you know, work-wise, I think productivity is huge, and we're already seeing it. I think personal life. I don't know. Maybe I'll take your beer reference, but more like you know, cross which restaurant should I pick? What's the perfect someone to read my mind in terms of
make that decision for you on that
yes.
front? Yes, yeah, exactly. Little agent
like
letting
that.
You knows your
yeah,
taste, your preferences,
exactly.
and also that you're a little hangry.
I give it,
and you,
hey,
need it. You need it within 20 minutes
this
today.
Is my
and, you know, whatever
and make
that
the
might
reservation.
Be.
Do all for me.
Yes. Like that.
I know. I think that planning the
yes.
logistics of this world will hopefully get a lot easier. All right, my final concluding question for you both. When we're at Boomi World 2026, what do you hope to be able to say then that you can't yet say today?
I can go. I want to have some, you know, big stat around new connectors that have been built with AI. I don't know if we've put a target on it, but I would love for that marketplace to have taken shape and for people to be seeing value and not feel inhibited when there's no native connector off the shelf because they can create it themselves.
Yeah, the same as Steve mentioned, like when they launched the AI agent solution for the first time, you know, they couldn't imagine that 1 year later that it will be more than 30,000. So definitely something that we want to see as well in the data integration piece. You know, the same success and yeah.
That's great.
Awesome, well we look forward to sharing those big numbers and seeing that success
you so
with
much.
You next year. Itamar and Taylor, thank you. This has been a wonderful interview, really appreciate it. And thank you, Paul, and thank all of you for tuning in to our 2 days of coverage here in Dallas, Texas at Boomi World 2025. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.